Indian football's future seems a little exciting suddenly, and it has a Spanish tinge to it. I'm here with Kabir, who has been signed by a Spanish third division club, and Anuj Gupta of Sudeva FC, as well as CD Olimpic de Xativa, who has signed Kabir to play in Spain alongside two other players. So, congrats, Kabir. What are your feelings now?
I'm excited for the season. It's a bit of a challenge, but let's see. I think it's for the best.
And Anuj, three of your awards have broken through in a way to the first team of the club. And what do you have to say of that? Is it a vindication of your processes and your belief?
I think I wish Vijay was here. I really want to say that Vijay, yaar, jo humne 4 saal pehle socha tha na, I think hum dono ki jo wo ek sapna tha na, ab shuru hua hai. So in a nutshell, I would like to say that when we started Sudeva in 2014, we really thought that yaar, one day we want our Indians to play in Spain, and that today or this season it has happened. Now it completely depends upon these three boys, how they will be able to perform when that opportunity of playing in the first 11 comes in. And I'm sure that in a month's time, they will get that chance. I personally feel it's destiny is in the making.
That's quite a lot of pressure on you, that everyone is looking at you and your two friends. By the way, I mean, can you just introduce the other two players as well? He is the goalkeeper in the team, and the other two?
Gogou, he is from Manipur, he is attacking midfielder, and Kabir Nath, he's a right winger. And I personally feel, Kabir's mother and father are from Assam, but they have been based in Gurgaon. And Kabir is from Delhi, Dilli ka munda hai, aur, I think all the three are very close to me, particularly Kabir, and I always feel shorter, as I always see that he is growing taller.
It's always good to look up to something, someone. Yeah. So yeah, but then there are a lot of youngsters in your club setup also, Sudeva setup as well, who would be looking up to you. I mean, not metaphorically, but literally as well. So there's a huge pressure on you that way. And also the additional pressure of being a goalkeeper in a fast-paced game unlike India, and also to make it to the playing 11 regularly.
I think there's a pressure on us every time. There's a pressure on everyone. There's a pressure on him, on me, on everyone. It's just we have to cope up with that pressure, you know. It's good to have pressure, you know. It helps you build character, you know. Helps you become more composed, you know, calm. It's a good thing. I see it in a good way.
I understand that you had a pre-season game, a full game, and then your coach from Spain, we had a chat with earlier, he was very excited about the saves you made. And can you take us through the match and your feelings as well, and whatever was going through your mind?
I think we played a weaker team, you know, because it was a friendly match and the coach was giving chances to young players like me. So we had a weaker team, and because it was a weaker team, I got a lot of balls towards me. I got a lot of chances. So, you know, it was just in the game. It was a good game indeed.
And you saved a penalty.
Yeah, I did.
So, what went through your mind? You're facing a Spaniard, I guess.
I think I just knew where he's going to shoot, so it was clear for me.
So that's kind of like presence of mind in a way, that the goalkeeper, the young goalkeeper, understands where he was going to go. I mean, that takes quite a lot of training or something like that. So, tell us what these boys have gone through in the months that they have been in Spain, which has prepped them so much so that they are confident about playing well in the full season.
I think, you know, I've always told one thing to all these boys, that no matter what level you are playing, remember one key word: enjoy. If you stop enjoying, you will stop performing. It doesn't matter if you had a bad day. Remember to forget, but work towards your mistakes. But in everything, enjoy it. As he rightly said, taking pressure is also a way of improving. So the biggest thing which I tell them is, remember, no matter what level you reach, always, 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 always enjoy. So if you keep on enjoying, then you would realize that you are performing better than your expectations. And so in the last 1 year, what they've done is they've worked towards their language. They've worked towards understanding the Spanish way of living, what kind of food they eat, and how they enjoy time when they're not playing football. So it's very important to come out of football when you're not playing football. Because if 24 hours you're thinking about football, it will not help you. So it's always important to de-stress yourself when you're not in football. So for instance, they love listening to music, they love playing their...
I'd rather ask him about the ways he enjoys, yeah, because he's a youngster. Obviously, he'll have better ideas.
I think there's a lot of things to do, you know, in the free time, apart from football. There are two training sessions in a day, one in the morning and then one in the evening. In between, you know, there's a afternoon nap, and then I have a few assignments I usually get from university, from my university. And music is one thing we all love over there, you know. We're always playing music, and sometimes, you know, going out. That's it. That's pretty much it.
PlayStation.
Not PlayStation, but we try to learn Spanish in the meantime, you know, trying to study Spanish.
I'm sure Anuj has imposed a curfew, so there's no late-nighters as such.
Oh, there is not, actually.
And that's bad. And the thing about Gogou, he's a fantastic guitarist.
Oh, yeah.
So that is something which he does when he's not playing football.
So house music.
Oh, I mean, I think he's better.
I think he's a good guitarist. And we often listen to him. He's a good guy.
So this high speaking has been done with the other Spanish players as such. Now, I mean, it's very evident from the way you are describing that you guys are a thick team, the Indians who are there. But what about your interactions with the Spanish crowd there, and as in the other players? And have they accepted you as a family, as their own? Or is there any barrier language, whatever?
There is barrier language, but as I said, they're good people, you know. They're good. They understand that we are coming from India. We're not that good for footballing nation. And they understand that. They help you in the training sessions, everywhere, on and off the field. They understand. There's a language barrier, yes, but they're supportive. Yeah, they understand that.
As a player, your immediate and long-term goal?
I think to play for India is my only goal. That is it. And, you know, sustain myself. In that league or in the higher league in Spain.
And as a club owner, your immediate future, what do you see? And long term, what do you see?
Long term is obviously, as Vijay and I always work towards, is to produce international players from India who will take India to the World Cup. That is the final goal. And during that, yes, the immediate goal is to produce players from India who can play for India at all age categories. And then, yeah, at the right age, we are able to take them to Spain, and then they give them the Spanish system, and so that they can start performing at the Spanish level. And yeah, hopefully maybe one day we'll be able to produce the one couple of Indians who can play for the top division in Spain. So
but you mentioned, I'm digressing it a little bit. You mentioned about producing players who will play for India and take India forward. But then it's ironic that a person who is good enough to be in the Spanish third division 22 has not been considered in the age group teams for India. So how is that happening?
I think, you know, they just got in. You know, now it will depend how much minutes they get. You know, what are the match, how well they do in the match. So I think this year would be very important for them to perform at that level. And yes, I think next year, if they perform well, I think it'll be just a matter of time when All India Football Federation would love to talk to me about these players. That's why I'm not in a hurry. Neither these boys should be in a hurry. I think it's just a matter of time. It's just like, so there is one more platform where Indian kids are able to get trained and get an opportunity. So in a way, it's really good for Indian football as well. And I really want to tell to all Indian football clubs as well that if such opportunity comes in, please, let's not think that, you know, we all are competitors. If we can work together, it'll be really good for the upcoming footballers.
After all, it's a team game. So yeah, on that note, congrats Kabir again, and also all the best for the challenges ahead. And congrats too, and you've been doing some great stuff, and hopefully more kids will follow. Thanks.